this is how it works. All right, so I've got my one image and my other image, which is why they're called image one and image two. All right. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to build what are called Gaussian pyramids. All right. And that's illustrated like this. So it's Gaussian pyramid of image one. We'll talk more extensively in a minute about how you might go about building those pyramids. This is just notionally so you understand what's going on. So now I have these reduced pyramids. At the top level, remember, I have that very blurry picture that actually only has a small number of pixels in it, and the motion between them is actually much smaller. And that's shown here, right? So here it says U is 10. So that's saying, let's suppose the shift is 10 pixels at the lowest level. Well, when I cut it in half, it becomes 5, then it becomes 2.5, then it becomes 1.25. I can keep going. So this is how I reduce the amount of motion that's present. So because I've reduced the amount of motion, I can first run Lucas and Conati between those coarsest level. And I might do the iterative thing. That's the thing we looked at last time, where I fit it plane, estimate it, shift it a little bit, estimate it, shift it a little bit, keep doing till I converge. So that will map the motion between the very reduced image one and the very reduced image two, right? So I can compare that. I can find the motion between them. The question then is, what do I do next? Well, what I have to do is I have to go from the coarser to the next finer level, okay? And what's written here is warp and upsample, all right? We're going to go through the details of that, but basically the way you can think about this is I compare something at a coarse level, then I know, okay, if I were to double up this image and double up that image, I'd have to double up the motion field. I'd also have to double the amount I'm moving. We'll do that algorithm in a minute. But I could apply that to the next level, and what that will do is that will get me the next level very close to the second image at that level, and I could run Lucas and Conati again. And then I can iterate and run that over again and eventually get the entire motion field.